There's no question renters in BC need to be protected from unscrupulous landlords. But a story out of North Vancouver tonight may have you wondering what's being done to prevent landlords from awful tenants. Alyssa Thibault reports on a homeowner who's been told he can't evict his renter because the renter was in jail.
This dramatic standoff in January lasted hours. A man barricaded himself in a basement suite, then arrested in a cloud of tear gas. But for the homeowner, the nightmare is lasting much longer.
He's still my tenant, if you can believe it.
Jason Rivero lives above his tenant and discovered thousands of dollars in damage in the suite. We reached him on vacation.
Basically, all the furniture is gone. He broke things. Hardwood floor has to be changed because of the canister, the tear gas canister, when it hit the ground and made a big dent.
Rivero wants to evict him using a special expedited process. But one of the conditions is the tenant has to be served an eviction notice in person.
I didn't have any way to serve the documents personally to this person because he was unreachable.
Unreachable because he was in jail. The eviction denied by the Residential Tenancy Board. The arbitrator saying, I acknowledge that the landlord made efforts to serve the tenant in person and that the landlord was unable to do so given the circumstances. However, this does not change the service requirements.
Why don't they use some criteria? And they see this out of this planet situation and they still do not take my claim as valid.
The tenancy agreement is up at the end of this month, so Rivero is planning to just ride it out. The housing ministry tells me the in-person notification doesn't apply to a regular eviction, but that can take up to 3 months. Alyssa Thibault, CTV News, Vancouver.